Hello everyone, this is Direwolf 20, and welcome to episode 24 of Direwolf 20's Fortress Craft Evolved series. Last episode, I made an orbital power transmitter. This thing is ginormous. And to match its ginormousness, it requires a ginormous amount of power. About 10 million, I think, is it? No, or is it 100 million? I forget. It's a lot. It's a number that's big enough that it doesn't matter how big it is, because you just have to keep pumping power into it until you're done. There's one catch to the orbital power transmitter. That is, if any of these bugs that are assaulting our base break through and manage to destroy our amazing central power hub here and break it down, the orbital power transmitter will quickly start losing its stored power charge. So basically, we want to make sure our base defenses are really quite in order before we get around to doing that. So one of the things that we want to focus on today is making sure that's the case. And to go along with that, we've made some cool things. I made missile turrets last episode. I haven't even checked them out yet, but I would like to. So we're going to get ready to load these guys up. Now, they're going to need some missiles. For now, I'm just going to place a storage hopper next to it. Set to machines can remove from you only. Cool. Can't find missiles in attached hopper. Searching for large targets. So the missile launcher won't waste missiles on small enemies, which is probably a really good thing. Now, what I want to make is a missile setup, dude. So let's get the stuff ready that we're going to need for that. So we're going to want... I've decided there's a couple approaches we can take to making missiles. So we made the missile launcher, but now we have to make missiles themselves. To go about doing that, we're going to either need a basic missile assembler, or we're going to need an empty missile assembler and a missile fueler. So missiles require three components. They require gold wires, copper tubes, and high energy fuel. That's the fuel that we've been pumping into our generators here. So right, each one will require one copper pipe, one gold wire, and one high energy composite fuel. Those three combined make a missile. So you can either combine the gold and the copper to make an empty missile assembler, and then route the empty missile into a missile fueler to combine it with that. So it's two inputs to one output on each of these, or you can put all three together, three inputs, one output. Both of these guys are gonna require power. I'm gonna try it out with this guy. So we're gonna need some titanium plates and some charged PCBs. Now that we've relocated our PCB assembler and all that good stuff, let's do this. Let's get from here. I'm going to get my stamper plants, my coilers, these guys. This is extrusion. This is pipe extrusion. Okay, coiler, PCB assembling, extrusion. Let's get these set up so that I can manually craft things like PCBs and whatnot, like we had before. Also, I'm seeing some resin here. Dun, dun, dun. Hardened resin is bad stuff. I think we're starting to see some enemies working their way up in this general direction. The fact that we have hardened resin right here, I don't think this was here before, and it's making me a little nervous. So we're gonna wanna keep an eye on this. Let's clean up these lines here that I've got. And what we'll probably do, so we'll have the stamper plant ready to go here, I think. What is that giant shadow? I don't know, but it's making me nervous. We'll have the stamper plant here, and then we will have the extrusion, followed by coiler, followed by PCB, just so I can manually craft some things. Cool. Might be that guy, but I don't know. So, as I recall, in order to craft... It was titanium, right? And charged. Okay, so titanium plates, 5. Charged PCB, 3. Let's just go ahead, I'm gonna check to see if I happen to have some of those. I do have some titanium plates. Okay, cool. And the lithium version of things. So let's get about 10 of these guys in here for now. That'll start that thing cruising. And then we'll be ready to actually craft the missile setup. So in order for this missile setup to work, I think what we're gonna want is the following. So first, we're going to need to set up something similar over here. I know that we need, and I'm gonna use slot 6 here, why not, for my pipe extrusion plant. pipe extrusion, that's going to be the copper input and output. So we'll input copper here. Now to go along with that, we're also going to want the extrusion plant, because we're going to want gold wire, right? And these guys can feed directly into, let's do this. I'm going to put it here and here. I'm going to make this the small amount of storage one, the logistics hopper, because we don't need a large backlog of that, I don't think. So let's make some logistics hoppers. That's one that can only hold two of each item. Put them here and here, set to remove only, so machines can remove from them. And then that's where we're going to put the block that isn't crafted yet, which we might be able to craft by now. 10 charged PCBs later, and we can hopefully make the basic missile assembler. Cool. Okay. That should be good.
Crafting.
Nice. Now we're also going to want a storage hopper on top, also set to remove only. That's where we're going to put our high energy composite fuels. For now, I'm going to have that be, this whole thing be a little bit of a manual process, but we're going to look into what's involved in making this automated soon. So there's your basic missile assembler, right? So let's place this dude down. Nice. So he's also going to need power. I don't know quite how much power he needs, but we're going to find out pretty quickly, because what we're going to do is have tier 2 laser going like so. Nice. Looking in attached hopper for one copper pipe, one high energy composite, and one gold wire. Nice. So let's do this. You here, and you here. So what we should see is this guy turning into a copper pipe. Dude, that is so cool. Like the little animations that run there, that is awesome. Cool. So cannot locate high energy composite fuel. Pretty sure that I shouldn't have any of that on me. I've been really trying to keep my inventory organized. I just noticed some things I want to clean out. So you can go here, as well as there's another set of those. There they are. Sorry. Okay. Let's get some high energy composite fuel, because I know I've got some sitting over here. Free 100. So there's some empty fuel canisters in here. What's this thing for exactly again? Oh, I see. Okay. I broke something when I changed something. Compact designs and all, guys. I broke something. That should organize that. So this has empty fuel canisters in it that are now being pumped into here. This was sending them. Okay, cool. And these things should start filling up now. We should be getting nice high energy composite fuels out of here, and this guy will start filling up as well. Good. This is the empty fuel canister coming from over there, right? And I had broken this conveyor to set up this new conveyor line, but I forgot that in breaking that, I defeated some of my automation there. So that's cool. Let's just get three of them for now. High energy composite fuel. Like I said, manual for now, automated maybe later, depending on how badly we're going to need missiles. Sweet. So this thing is running. Desire is 8. Wow. Okay, cool. So you guys running or what? Probably doesn't have an output buffer, so we'll make that happen. Add only. Aha, there's your problem, dire derp. Cool, now we're getting power. Sweet, so now we know it requires 8 power per second, which means that we should be plenty. With this guy. He should have no problem supplying 8. In fairness, I could probably do this with a tier 1 laser even, right? Because tier 1s can do 10. Yeah. So this could really be done with a tier 1. No sense in wasting it. That should be fine. Nice. So now we should have a missile here. 2 missiles, actually. Sweet. Missile turret, Mark 2 turret, awesome. Where'd those missiles go here? So we should get 1 missile for every... Yeah, there we go. So that's the 3 that matches. Cool. Now if I pop this dude in here... Oh, that is cool. Look at that thing ready to fire. Nice. Alright, 1 missile loaded. Next shot's damage is 75,000. Nice. And he only searches for large targets, so that's cool. 4512 damage on that. So this does 4,000 damage per shot. This does 75,000 damage per shot. That is so cool. I want more missiles. I want more missiles. We're probably going to want to automate this in some way. Now that I'm thinking about it. So we're going to need a decent amount of gold and copper storage. Storing a large amount of gold and copper isn't going to be too easy. Gold we have to bring up. Copper we've already got up here. But yeah, see how it's not wasting the missiles on these little measly targets? But trust me, if a big guy comes, hopefully I'll get it on camera the first time it happens. But I'm sure I will get it on camera at some point. Let's think about how I can automate this. I know there's a way to automate the empty canisters, isn't there? Empty fuel canisters? Yes. Those just require iron pipes, which, oh, I guess he changed it so that I need to use that pipe machine there. Okay, good to know. See what I said about, I'm telling you, like, every time I play this game, there's been changes and tweaks and additions and new things to play with. It's one of the things that's very cool. Alright, let's think. Let me come back in a minute. I'm going to look at how I might automate the empty fuel canister production. Obviously, it's just iron, right? So, like, iron pipe becomes empty fuel canister. Pretty straightforward. I just have to figure out exactly how I'm going to do it. Alright guys, it seems to me like the best place to set up shop here would be something like this, right? So we've got copper right here. So let's redo a little bit of what we just did. This would come in here, this would come along here, so we would have a logistics hopper here and here, and then right here this guy would be that. Well, actually, no, wait, we want the pipe extrusion, right? Yeah, we want this to be the pipe extrusion plant. There we go. Cool, so that'll pipe extrude, take care of that, boom, right? This will be your high energy composite fuel. Which I probably have some in my inventory now, so I want to put that back here. That should be good. And then we'll have the basic missile assembler. Cannot locate gold wire. That's okay, because we're going to have you with a extrusion plant. And this will be this guy that I'll set to have 100 gold for now. So now you should have everything you need, right? Once that extrudes. Except for power, of course. Nice. There we go. And I should be able to access power down here somewhere. There should be a power source going on. So let's say we'll put this guy back. And remember, I can use... Ooh, that's like really close to being a good place to be. You know what? Even better? If I put this here, that should go right to there. That's better. Yep, just a little bit more efficient. So So now all we need is a drop off. So let's make sure that you're set to machines can remove, machines can remove, machines can remove. And you're looking for a place to put that. We're gonna make that a storage hopper set to pattern. So now missiles are coming in. So the only manual part of this at the moment would be gold. So that's pretty cool. Now, as it relates to these guys, how do we wanna do empty fuel canisters? Because pretty much every empty fuel canister I've gotten thus far, I've been crafting, right, and putting into this closed system. Like, for example, when this generator uses up all its fuel, the empty fuel canister gets dumped into a hopper, right? And then it just gets refilled with fuel over here. That's not the case for missiles. Missiles, unfortunately, oh man, look at how cool that is to watch that craft. I gotta say, there's some really good animations in this game. That is awesome, actually. Rocket. I got distracted by fancy looking animations. The long story short, what was I saying? Some things about stuff. That's right. You're crafting and having a good time. So anyway, we're gonna need to auto craft some of these, I think. I wonder if I could have another refinery controller on the same refinery. If I could do that, that would be cool. Let me check that real quick. Alright guys, let's see what we can do by way of automated empty canister production. So what I would like then would be pipe extrusion into a logistics hopper should be fine, and that should be iron pipes. Cool. And then, oh by the way, I have my jetpack on. I found it's very handy for getting out of tight spaces. From there, we're going to want to probably have an energy cell here and a manufacturing plant. I forget what's involved in crafting one of those, but we're gonna find out really soon. Manufacturing plant, where would you even be? I don't even know what tab to consider that under. I don't think it's on this one. Maybe this one? Manufacturing plant, there he is. All right, let me get all that stuff. And there we go.
Crafting.
So we will take our manufacturing plant over here. It's gonna need power, so maybe I'll do that now. I'm not entirely sure how much power. So let's start with a tier one laser and we'll see how that works out. You could probably be, let's do tier one for now. And if it needs to be a tier two, I'll up it. How's that sound? So you could go here. Yeah, that's fine. So manufacturing plant goes here, and I'm going to configure this guy to automatically craft empty fuel canisters, automate. Is that working? Oh, look at that, it goes, nice. Cool. I don't know how much power it needs. It's saying out of power, which makes me concerned that it might not be getting enough. So we should set this guy to remove only. This guy could be a tier 2 maybe? If I could aim. That should be sufficient to keep you happy, right? A little bit better. Nice. That's just a degradation of transfer there. So I'm gonna make these tier twos, I think. And now we should be talking. So that should have now, I'm gonna make this a logistics hopper set to add only. And I'm assuming that you will then output to the adjacent position, right? There's four in there. Wonder what its internal capacity is. Wonder if it'll tell me. Automation. Let's read that real quick. So according to the help file, and my testing that I just did, it has to be an attached storage hopper. It won't dump into a logistics hopper, which is weird. But that's okay. Let's now go down a little bit. So what I would like to do is get that over to here. So all we should really need to do, and boy, is this going to be tricky. because reasons. Because there's a laser here, isn't there? That's going to be extra tricky. Oh boy. I am making these machines far more compact, I think, than the developer ever really meant. He's always like, I expect machines to be built big, and Dyer's always making machines really compact and small. So let's see, how am I going to do this? I should actually be able to do something like... I also want it to like look a little bit nice, that would be ideal. I mean, I could run it above, but you know what I could do is actually just run it one level down. See, that would intersect with this one, though. I really want him to... Well, I guess for now what I'll do, it's because it actually will work just fine. That, right? So that should do that, and then these things start running, as you can see. Cool. So that'll run, and that'll be good. I mean, I've got 5,500 iron, so I think letting this automation line run is probably not the end of the world. That should be cool. So you'll continue to run. So the slowdown will be this. He actually looks like he's still struggling a little bit to have all the power he needs, isn't he? That's interesting, because he's got a full power storage under him, but he's struggling a little bit. Not terrible. I mean, he's pretty much running at full speed. I wonder if there's anything that it records about how much power he can accept. No numbers on it, it looks like, but that's okay. All right, let's leave that be for a bit, but I think that'll do. So that'll really get our automated amount of missiles going. Now, the only downside that we have thus far is we have yet to automate getting the missiles over to the rocket launcher. Though I could put my rocket launcher right next to my missile production line. These things have a really long radius, by the way. Like, I think their minimum range, according to this, is 64 blocks, maximum range 512. So you know what I could do? Nuts to moving it too far. Let's just, you know, pick this guy up, pick this guy up. We actually don't even need you guys here anymore because we're about to change this up. Jetpack away. Clear that up. What if I just put my missile launchers like right over here? There's plenty of power coming this way, isn't there? So since this is a decent amount of, that would be cool, right? So just for now, because I might want multiple missile launchers later, right? So for now, we'll just pop this guy into what I will say will be a logistics hopper with a missile launcher right next to him. How's that? Perfect. He's already got his missile loaded, so that's cool. Nice, right? I like that plan. All right, let's make sure that this thing has a sufficient amount of power at all times. I think I'm going to make that a tier 3. I don't know how much power he requires to fire. He shouldn't be firing too often. Damage per missile, missiles per salvo, reload time is 15 seconds, so that's not terrible. But it doesn't really talk about power. Let's go with tier 2 energy transfer for now. Just want to figure out like the most efficient way to get power over there. Yeah, that's actual ground there. I don't want to do that if I can avoid it. Let's go through here. So this will be something like straight up to there. So I think I'll do tier 2 power. That should be sufficient. You're good. So right along this line. So if I had something like that. I'm thinking a tier 2 power cell right there. Feeding that up to there. And then this could eventually become multiple missile batteries, right? We'll just see how bad things get. But for now, I'm gonna call that automated missiles, right? And because this thing has a 512 block range, like, he should have no problem shooting off in that direction, right? And just covering the whole base. Even though he's kind of not in the center of my base, like 512 blocks is a lot of blocks. So I shouldn't have any problems with that. And eventually we could have like another missile launcher here and here. And if we really got into trouble, we could have like, a conveyor turntable, and then we could have a missile launcher here, 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 right? So, like, realistically, we could have, like, 10 missile launchers right here. That would be good. All right, cool. So that's fully automated minus the gold, which I unfortunately have to keep adding here. I mean, I could just have another storage hopper if I really wanted to and just do that. Right, and now I've got 200 gold backlog. Not that that's fully automated, but it's better than nothing for now. Because getting gold up from down there will be trickier than it sounds. All right, let's come back in a minute. So you guys probably caught it, but I blocked my matter mover. Derp. So, fixed. I knew you guys would yell. You'd be like, dire ears. Broke your matter mover. I know, I derp. But then I catch it. I do. I notice it eventually, but that's cool now. So that should be fine. Jetpack off. Jetpack is cool, but not used to using jetpack all the time. So, okay, so that's good now. Let's see, I think I accidentally picked up an empty fuel canister, which doesn't need to go there anymore. So we'll just test, but I think I saw one go through already, so we're cool. Nice. All right, guys, I just made a bunch of tier 3 power transmitters. So I'm thinking, how should I do this? Let's line all this stuff up. That should be cool. If I really wanted this thing to cruise, not that these have to be here, but it'll just make it easier for me to pay attention to what I have to do. That should be good. That should be good. Can you just hit like that? Is that how it works? Oh yeah, look at that, we're getting power. All right, we're on our way. We have a lot more to go. I'm pretty sure, by the way, that I can't just do this, right? Like, it actually needs to be collected off of like that. Oh wait, no, that works. Okay, never mind. Hold on. Hold your horses. That changes things. Right? Because if that works, then I can do this and this. So that gives me 4 going into there, right? So that's a large amount of power going in at that point. Nice. Look, we're draining our tier 4 battery, which is what I want to do, because I think I want to move it. Again, I know. But if this thing's here, then I should really put my tier 4 battery. So that is a 3x3x3, right? So if I was being smart, which I'm not always, as apparent by the fact that I want to move it again, I think what I'd want to do is something like here, right? So I can have... just straight up boom, right? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Like that, pretty much. And if that was my tier 3 battery, then I could just have 9 lasers in the front, boom, hitting that thing straight up. I mean, it looks like I've gotten a lot of power already. Like, I'm already up to almost 100,000, but I need like 100 million, so I need a lot more than that. Plus, I'm using a huge amount of my tier 4 battery's capacity. So what I think I'll probably do is drain that thing and then look at rewiring some of my wiring. So this is all hooking off the jet turbine, which is cruising right now and like running at full steam. It hasn't been running too much because it hasn't needed to generate that much power. But as you can see now, tons of air intake and giant laser out the back telling me the jet turbine is running very, very fast. I think off camera, I'll probably rearrange some of the laser setup here because obviously it's a bit of a mess at this point. But this way I can at least not waste the large amount of power that's sitting in here. I mean, it's relatively large. It's not that large. And I'll consider maybe even a tier 5 battery, but I don't know. We'll see. And I should also at least craft the components for another turbine. So what I'll do is wrap up the episode here. We'll come back next time. We will have moved the tier 4 battery and start talking about making sure that our base is well defended from the onslaught of bugs that I expect as a result of starting to charge up this thing. Oh, that is cool. It's actually a really neat effect as it's being powered up. See, look, it's 0.19. Like, we haven't even charged it 1% yet. We've charged it 1/5 of 1% at this point. That's a lot of power that it needs. 1/5 of 1%. All right, guys, for now, Direwolf20 signing off. Hope you've enjoyed the episode. Automated, like 90% automated if you don't count gold bars. The process of creating missiles, which is always good because missiles are good and everybody likes missiles. We've got actually a decent amount in here. We've already created 65 missiles. We've got a, you know, automated production line going here. I wish the manufacturing plant was a little bit faster, but that's okay. And he's being funny about his power demands because he's sitting on top of a full tier 2. So I don't know what he needs or what he wants, but I will keep an eye on him for now. All right, guys, Direwolf20 signing off. Take it easy.